Hi, it's me, Tim Dodd, the Everyday Astronaut. So, you're in Florida and you want to watch a rocket launch live. Perhaps Falcon Heavy. Maybe another SpaceX rocket. Or perhaps even a different launch provider's rocket. Well, today I wanted to give you a rundown on the best locations for watching rockets launch on the space coast. We'll show you pictures and videos from each location to help you make the best decision on launch day. I also got tips from people on Twitter to help give you some advice on how to best be prepared. But say you can't make it down to Florida, where can you watch online? I'll let you know the best places for that too. Let's get started.
3, 2, 1.
This particular video will be timed out with the maiden launch of Falcon Heavy. So, those of you trying to catch this exciting launch in person will know exactly where to watch. But wait, Tim, I'm from the future and the Falcon Heavy already launched. Well, guess what, future people? You're in luck. This video applies to all launches from Florida. But please note, this video only applies to launches from Florida, and we'll do a video specific to launches from Vandenberg Air Force Base in California, or maybe other launch sites in a future video as well. And may I suggest one more thing here quickly. If you're going to watch a SpaceX launch and need a quick rundown on all things SpaceX, including launch vocabulary, what rockets they launch, where they launch, and where they land, make sure and check out my complete guide to SpaceX series. So first off, you're looking to watch a launch either in person or online. You're gonna wanna stay tuned in to the launch date and time. And by stay tuned in, I mean stay tuned in. The date you see on any launch is a net date, and that stands for no earlier than, and this is important. Plan on rocket dates changing. The further out you are, say a month or more, the more likely the date is to change. The closer you are, say within a day, the more likely that launch date will happen as advertised. This is because there are so many things that need to happen leading up to a launch. The rockets themselves need to arrive to their launch site, and then the payload needs to arrive as well. Then the payload is connected to the rocket, and everything needs to be checked out several times before they actually give the go for launch. If at any point leading up to this, something goes wrong, that date will slip. My preferred way to know how to stay tuned into a rocket date is by having a few select apps on my phone. If you're specifically trying to stay tuned into SpaceX launches, there is no better app than the SpaceX Now app. They will notify you of any changes, any news updates from Reddit, or any official tweets from Elon or SpaceX. My next favorite app for launches on the space coast is the We Are Go Vacation Knots app. This app is super fun if you're out vacationing and trying to catch a launch. They have a great up-to-date launch calendar, missions with badges, quizzes, polls, and check-ins. It's a super fun way to get the most out of your vacation while being plugged into launches. This app is only specific to Florida launches though, which may or may not be a good thing, depending on what you want. And one more good app for launch dates and times is the Launch Alarm app. It will also notify you of any changes for upcoming launches, including launches not only from other US sites, but also from other countries as well. And lastly, if you're not an app type person, go ahead and check out spaceflightnow.com for their wonderful launch section as well. So I think that's my first tip. Stay as plugged into the launch date and time leading up to the launch as humanly possible. Then there's launch day. If you've tuned into previous launches, you know sometimes they get right up to T-minus zero and the rocket stays on the pad. Again, there's just so many variables, including weather, boats or planes wandering into the rocket's path, and any mechanical issues that might pop up last minute as they load the rocket with fuel and prepare for launch. Moral of the story? You're not going to see a rocket launch. You're going to try to see a rocket launch. I know that might sound harsh, but that's just simply the reality of it. Rockets aren't like trains, boats, airplanes, or anything else with an easy schedule. It's best not to hold your breath until you see the rocket leave the launch pad. So I guess that's my second tip. Plan on a scrub or a delay, and only be extra surprised if there isn't one. Flexibility is key when planning this, but I know that's not always an option. But hopefully, for my sake, your sake, the ground crew support's sake, and anyone else's involved sake, the delay is only a single day and not some major setback of days or weeks. Okay, so now you know when a rocket is going to launch. So now where or where should you go to see a rocket launch from? If you're at home and your home isn't in Florida, then you can just tune into YouTube for the easiest launch experience. Subscribe to SpaceX, ULA, NASA, Orbital ATK, Rocket Lab, ESA, Blue Origin, or any other of your favorite launch providers or agencies if you want to be notified when they go live. But perhaps even more fun, you can join me during my live streams when I cover launches. I'm available from around T-minus 30 minutes for most launches to answer your questions live. So make sure you're subscribed here so you know when that will occur. When I attend a launch in person, like I will be for Falcon Heavy, I'll be live streaming from Kennedy Space Center's press site as well. So you'll get an excellent live view from only 3 miles away. But if you're trying to see a launch in person, we need to do a quick summary of the different launch sites and landing pads. SpaceX will be launching Falcon Heavy from historic Launch Pad 39A in Kennedy Space Center. Nearby to that is NASA's 39B, where SLS will eventually launch from. Then, down south, we have, in order from north to south, Slick 41, where ULA launches their Atlas V rocket, Slick 40, where SpaceX launches their Falcon 9 rocket, Slick 37, where ULA launches Delta IV and Delta IV Heavy, and of course, Landing Zone 1, or LZ1, and LZ2, which is right next to it. That's right, we have landing zones, and that's because SpaceX lands their Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy boosters, sometimes here at land. There are several places to view launches from, some closer than others, but closer might not always be better due to obstructed views. Here's a rundown on the most common public places. If you're early enough, you can buy tickets directly from NASA's Kennedy Space Center Visitor Complex, which can get you some of the best views from inside Kennedy Space Center. The options vary depending on different launches. There are three different options that might be available that actually get you inside the gates of the Space Center and beyond the Visitor Center. First off, there's the Saturn V Center, which is easily one of the best views the general public can get, especially for Pad 39A and 39B. At just 3.9 miles or 6 kilometers away from 39A, this is easily one of the best views in the house for SpaceX launches from 39A. This one is also called Banana Creek Viewing if you can't find Saturn V Center on their website or on Google. For the inaugural launch of Falcon Heavy, this is the only publicly available option from inside the Space Center, and unfortunately, it's already sold out. Then there's the Gantry. This place is super close to Slick 41 for Atlas V launches. At only 2.3 miles or 3.7 kilometers away, this site can be quite the experience. It's not always an option though, but when it is, they make up for the higher ticket price by giving you a unique shirt and a meal. And lastly, there's the Nasa Causeway. The Causeway offers a good view of all the launch pads, ranging from around 8 miles or around 13 kilometers away from 39B and just under 3 miles or 4.5 kilometers away from Slick 37. This is the closest you can get to the landing pad at just 4 miles or 6.4 kilometers away. This one isn't offered very often, usually only for high profile NASA launches or the press. Otherwise, for most launches, you can watch from the Visitor Center, which, although it doesn't offer a direct line of sight to the launch pads due to trees being in the way, they do have bleachers, jumbotrons, guest speakers, and of course, excellent amenities. You'll get a great view once the rocket leaves the pad at around 7 miles or 11 kilometers away from most launch pads. You can check pricing and availability of these options starting about 2 weeks before launch at their website. They'll usually announce on Twitter, at ExploreSpaceKSC, when tickets go on sale. Then, you can purchase tickets by visiting kennedyspacecenter.com and click on tickets. The next most common option, and possibly an even better option, is Jetty Park in Port Canaveral. Although Jetty Park is 14 miles or 22.5 kilometers away from 39A, and although you can't see ignition due to a berm that blocks the direct line of sight to the launch pad, at just 6 miles or 9.6 kilometers away from the landing pad, Jetty Park is quite the experience. It will be crowded. It's one of the most popular spots to view from. It's technically the closest and best view you can get of the landing pad, but this does not apply for launches that aren't landing back at land, or dare I say it, an expendable launch vehicle like non-SpaceX rockets. They have bathrooms and a restaurant as well. It'll cost around $15 per car and will fill up quickly, so get there plenty early. The next most common public view is from State Road 401 at the southern entrance to the Cape Canaveral Air Force Station. This is perhaps one of the best views for the launch pad itself if seeing the rocket at ignition is important to you. At just 13 miles or 21 kilometers away, you're looking directly over the Banana River straight to Pad 39A and have a pretty great view of other launch sites as well. The only issue with this vantage point is there can be a very large building that partially obscures the view of the landings. But at 6 miles or 9.6 kilometers away, you're pretty darn close. Again, plan on this area being really, really busy. Next, we have another option that's great for launches out of Launch Pad 39A, like the Falcon Heavy. It's the Max Brewer Bridge. It offers an elevated view that's pretty darn close, too. At 11 miles or 18 kilometers, you get a really good view of takeoff, but you're about as far away from landings as possible. At 17.5 miles or 28 kilometers away, you won't get nearly as much out of the landing experience. Next up, we have the closest the general public can get to launches, but this place isn't always an option, and boy does it have some drawbacks. Playalinda Beach is only 3.5 miles or 5.7 kilometers away from Pad 39A, which means it most likely won't be open for Falcon Heavy, but it is an excellent choice for other launches. It is, however, very far away from the landing site again at 12.5 miles or 20 kilometers away. But remember, most rockets don't land back on land, most land at sea or don't land at all. So perhaps this excellent view of the pad is well worth it. Another bad thing is its remote location with little to no cell phone service. It also has very limited bathrooms and zero amenities otherwise. Visit this website, there's a link in the description or call this phone number if you'd like to see if the Playalinda Beach is open for the launch you're trying to attend. Next up, we have Exploration Tower, which isn't always open for launches, but if you have the opportunity, definitely check it out. They're open from 10 a.m. till 5 p.m. and sometimes as late as 7 p.m., but it offers excellent views of all launch pads and the landing zones. It's cheap too, only $15 on launch days for adults. However, it's not always available to public on launch days as occasionally SpaceX uses it as a press site. There are also many parks and other places along Highway 1, which runs along the Indian River. I don't want to get into all of these, but they do oftentimes offer decent views and may be close enough to different amenities that you can easily park and then walk to grab food or find a restroom. And lastly, if you're pretty much anywhere along the beach from Cape Canaveral down to Cocoa Beach, you will for sure be able to see it. Just not as well as some other places. But I'll bet it's pretty hard to beat swimming in the ocean while watching a rocket launch over you. Or maybe hanging out on the Cocoa Beach Pier for entertainment and restaurants. So if all this is overwhelming, may I suggest checking out launchrats.com. Launchrats has plotted out many different places to view launches. If you want a great resource to be able to quickly look and plot out your next move, I highly suggest it. Another great website is professional launch photographer Ben Cooper's rocket launch viewing guide for Cape Canaveral on his website, launchphotography.com. Again, there's a link in the description. Wow. Okay, so for tip number three, know where you're going and get there early. SpaceX launches draw some pretty big crowds these days, and Falcon Heavy will certainly be one of the biggest launches since NASA's EFT Orion mission, or maybe even getting close to the amount of people who came down to watch the last space shuttle launch, STS-135 in 2011. I asked people on Twitter to give me their best tips for viewing a launch. Here's a few of my favorites. My friends the Negles said, "We packed the minivan with bicycles, chairs, coolers, binoculars, and lots of water. We arrive at the coast very early, set up camp, and then we bike out to breakfast or lunch, etc. Early arrival is key, and be in no hurry to leave after. The social aspect is half the fun." Carolyn Hutchins also recommends getting there early to stake out your spot first and bring a picnic lunch too. Trip Harris recommends, "If you've never seen a launch, leave your camera at home and instead just watch with your own eyes. There will be plenty of great photos available from guys like John Krause Photos anyways."
Boy, isn't that the truth.
This leave your camera at home mantra was echoed over and over again, such as tweets from Jose King, Jamie Rich, Yisrael, and Kevin. Julia expanded on the importance of living in the moment by saying, "Enjoy the experience. What did you see, hear, feel? A picture is just a moment, but a launch is so much more. The person standing next to you, say hello. You may find out they worked on the shuttle or Apollo program. Launches are a shared experience. Enjoy." And that last part I especially love. Meet people. You're all there for the same thing, to witness the magic of spaceflight. Watching a rocket break Earth's gravity and propel itself towards the heavens. Inspire each other and share the moment together. As a professional photographer, I agree. Sure, snap one picture with your phone or put your camera on a tripod and click it once, but don't worry about your grainy cell phone pictures and instead take in the experience. The general consensus is to get there really early, like at least 3 hours, and for busy launches like Falcon Heavy, maybe more like 6 or 8 hours early. Pat O says, "Be prepared for a spectrum of emotions. The pre-launch hype, the chance for a disappointing scrub, the intensity when it actually launches, and the sadness when it's over." Fellow space journalist Robin C. Mangle says, "Mosquito repellent. Lots and lots of mosquito repellent and snacks." Holly recommends downloading a radio scanner app to listen to Kennedy Space Center communications to get an accurate listen to the countdown and some of the launch prep. Kathy has a friendly reminder about trash. "Please pick up your trash. Kennedy Space Center is in the middle of a federally protected wildlife area and people need to respect that." And lastly, my favorite YouTube space show, Tomorrow, has the ultimate advice. "Don't stand next to the rocket at liftoff." Thanks, guys. So tip number four is this: get there early, bring food, water, maybe a bike or two, some comfy chairs, sunscreen, patience pants, and perhaps leave your camera at home. Due to this massive flood of information I've just given you, I've linked to lots of resources, including a transcript of this video, on my website with the relevant links in the description below. I hope all this information helps you be as prepared as humanly possible for a launch. Am I forgetting anything important? If so, leave that in the comments below. Have you ever been to a launch? What was your first launch? And what was it like? As always, I owe a huge thanks to my Patreon supporters for helping make this and other everyday astronaut content possible. I owe a special thanks to those patrons in our exclusive Discord channel for helping me script and research. If you want to help contribute, please visit patreon.com/everydayastronaut. Thank you. Don't forget to check out my web store for shirts, hats, mugs, prints of rocket launches, and other original artwork, and lots of other fun stuff at everydayastronaut.com/shop. And as always, all the music in my videos is original. Feel free to check it out and download it for free at soundcloud.com/everydayastronaut. Tell a friend. Thanks, everybody. That does it for me. I'm Tim Dodd, the Everyday Astronaut, bringing space down to Earth for everyday people.